So this morning we, I want us to rise up and thank God for you. Welcome to you.
Hallelujah. Amen. Just leave your seat, embrace one thousand people and say you're welcome to World Mission Beko Big 7. That's our culture here. I say leave your seat, welcome at least 1,000 people. You're welcome to World Mission where good things happen. Something good will surely happen to you today. My story cannot end in this chapter. Do you believe me? I said, prophesy to yourself. My story cannot end in this chapter. Are you convinced? I said, that's a prophecy. Say, my story cannot end in this chapter. Oh my God. Say, neighbor, my story. The way you are behaving, I'm not sure. I say, thus says the Lord. Thus says the Lord. My story cannot end in this chapter. Have your seat in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Oh my God. As I began to pray last night and God gave me this word, so tell them their story cannot end in this chapter. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. The best chapters about you are yet to be written.
Amen.
The best chapters about you are just about to be written. I think about Nelson Mandela. He was 27 years in prison. And they told him, you go to die in prison. After 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, he came sick in prison. African prison is hell.
Yeah.
I mean, it's terrible. Mm-hmm. 10 years in prison of no hope, no release, no bail. 20 years in prison, the devil said, your story, Mandela, will end that way. Mm-hmm. And Mandela began to believe that my story cannot end in this chapter. My story cannot end this way. Say the name of Jesus. My story cannot end this way. My best days are just about to begin. I have a ministry ahead of me. I have a future ahead of me. I have a career ahead of me. I have life ahead of me. My story cannot end here. Hey, my story cannot end this way. My story cannot end this way. After 27 years, Nelson Mandela came out of prison and ran as a party leader, became a president.
Mm.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Your story cannot end this way.
Amen.
I think of Joseph when he was caught by his brothers, well beaten, and they struck him of his dress,
yeah,
and they cast him in a pit with mud.
Mm.
Hello?
Hi.
Now, if you go to Middle East, okay? Because they are in a desert, the wells are deep. To get water in Jerusalem, you need to at least go 100 meters. It's for, like those who are in Cameroon, Boya. If you fall in a well in Boya, Araboyatan, Bodalionga, you need help to come out. Because at least 60, 70 meters to get water. Can you see Joseph cast in a well and there no hope, no friend, no address, no internet, no satellite, no hope? And the devil said to Joseph, your story will end there. He was there for hours screaming, help! And there was no help. The devil said to Joseph, your story will end here. But Joseph, by the grace of God, his brothers pulled him out and sold him as a slave. And in Egypt, in a slave, in a foreign land, as a slave, the devil said, your story will end there. Say the name of Jesus. The same God of Moses, the God of Joseph, who changed their story. I declare today, my story cannot end in this chapter. Say, my story cannot end in this chapter. My story cannot end in this chapter. My story cannot end in this chapter. Hey, say, my story cannot end in this chapter. My story cannot end in this chapter. My best days are about to be written. Hallelujah. As a young pastor from Bible school, I was sent to a village of 5 zinc houses and 45 mud houses. My first station as a pastor, 5 zinc houses, village, 45 mud houses. When I was dropped there, I wondered, why am I here? I look around. I mean, you stand, you see the end of the village, left and right, you see the end. And I shed tears. I move around. There is no place to buy. There's no shop in the whole village. You hear me? There was no shop in that whole village. You cannot buy much, single much in the village. There's no boutique, call it boutique or something. There's no store, no shop. Okay? No water taps. You have to go and fetch water in the stream. Toilets are the biggest football pole behind the house. Football pole somewhere. You have to climb on the pole somewhere. That's the toilet. And my friends were calling me home. I'm in Yaounde. I'm in Babusam. I'm in this. And what am I doing here? The chief of the village got born again. Chief Pierre got born again. And the mission sent me to pastor one man in the village. The chief of the village got born again. So I went there. There was no church. The chief took me to a classroom, so okay, we'll meet you here on Sunday for church. Yeah. And that born again was not even serious born again. He just went to town and joined it, went to church. He gave the church with a snuff, not snuff, tobacco. Yeah, that's not everybody. The devil told me your story will end here. Your story will end here. This morning the Lord is saying to you, your story cannot end this way. Exodus, please. Exodus 2, verse 3 and verse 5. I want to go to do this very fast, please. Exodus 2, verse 3 to 6. Exodus 2, 3 to 6. And when she came, and when she could no longer hide him, that is Moses, she took him. Are you there? Exodus 2, 3 and 2, 6. And when she could no longer hide him, she took for him an ark of bulrushes and doubled it with slim and with pitch and put the child therein. And she laid it in a flax by the river's bank of brick. And his sister stood a Pharaoh to wit what would be done to him. And the daughter of Pharaoh came down to wash herself at the river. And her maidens walked along by the river's side. And when she saw the ark above the flax, she sent her maid to fetch it. And when she had opened it, she saw the child. And behold, the babe wept. And she had compassion on him. And said, this is one of the Hebrews' children. Say, my story cannot end this way. My story cannot end here. These were children in Egypt. Because you were born in a Jewish family, you'll say he was born on Friday 10 a.m., died on Friday 10:01 a.m. Once a son is born, they kill the child. And thousands of children were killed. Born on Saturday, 8 a.m. Died on Saturday, 8:05 a.m. Every male child was killed. One woman delivered this boy. And Bible says she sensed in her spirit that this child was a proper child. Divine child. Gifted child. So she dared to hide that child for 3 months. And when the child could not hide the child anymore, look for means to, you know, just by faith, took the child by the riverside and dropped the child there. And the child was crying. When Pharaoh's daughter saw this child, she had two options. This is one of the Hebrews' children. Kill that boy. But he did not say kill the boy. Are you following me? Yep. He had compassion and took this boy This same Joseph, this same Moses, became a prince, became a leader, became a deliverer. Say the name of Jesus. No devil could stop the destiny of Moses. Hey, say no devil could stop the destiny of Moses. No devil can stop my destiny. Hey, say no devil could stop the destiny of Moses. No devil can stop my destiny. My story cannot end this way. My story cannot end here. Hallelujah. Say no, your story cannot end here. Maybe you are tired of your story. Oh. Maybe you are tired of your story. And you want a shift in your life. You're tired of your story. The Bible said there was a man called Paul and Silas. Acts 16:22-24. Acts 16:22-24. Paul and Silas were in ministry and they cast out a devil from a girl. And that thing landed in prison. They were well beaten. Beaten and on chains. They dropped them in prison with a death sentence on them. Tomorrow, get them out for execution. And while in prison, they gave them order to put them in the innermost prison, no escape. Hello? I just imagine you being chained, your hands are chained, your legs are chained. Hello? Can you imagine? Yeah. And dropped in prison. They will say, Paul, your ministry ends here. Tomorrow you are there. Your story ends this way. And while at midnight, Paul and Silas begin to pray. They begin to sing. And Bible says what? The doors open. Hallelujah. Say the name of Jesus. The same God of Moses. The same God of Paul. That changed their story. My story cannot end this way. My story cannot end here. My story cannot end this condition. There is a future for my life. Maybe you are being tossed to and fro with thoughts that you will end this way. That you will end this way. Maybe you pray until you give it up prayers. Devil says you end single. You end without a good job. You end struggling. Maybe you've been here this nation and you know things are not going the way you want. And the devil is whispering to you that your story will end this way. This morning the Lord is saying, release this word to your people, that your story will not end this way. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. And I thought of my life some years ago. I was living in a house, mosquito house. No mosquito house. Yes. One day I entered my house and I saw my children, there was like a sea of mosquito sleeping on the body. But I entered one of my rooms and I saw a wall painted with blood. Have you ever seen a room like that? This is not a joke, eh? This is real. You see a wall painted with what? Blood. Because they kill mosquitoes on the wall. So they kill them. In the next 1 year, the whole wall is painted red. Devil said your story will end this way. The God is saying your new chapter is about to be written.
Oh, yes.
And at least in your life, the best you is about to manifest. Say the name of Jesus. The best me manifest. Hey, talk to yourself. Say the best me manifest. The best me manifest. The best me manifest. The greater me manifest. The best me manifests. The best of me manifests. God has so much in store for you. Eyes have not seen. Ears have not heard. So Paul and Silas, their story did not end there. In Acts 12, verse 1 to 3, is a story of a man called Peter. Are you following myself? And Herod asked him, who should be killed next? He said, Peter. Kill Peter, close the church. And therefore, he captured Peter and put him in prison to be killed the next morning. Hello? Aye. The devil said, Peter, Your story is over. Say never. The devil just preparing my big testimony. The devil just preparing a big testimony. So Peter was captured and locked up and said, tomorrow, take him out in the city center and kill him. I love Peter. Say, I love Peter. Peter had no stress. Peter went to prison and said, I'm not praying about this. I'm not fasting about this. It's time to get a good sleep. And he slept. And then angel said, Peter, get up. Obviously, the angel slapped Peter and said, Peter, get up. And he got up. Said, well, don't put all your sandals. And Peter got up, walked through the first. Hello, sister Anne. Are you following us up? He walked, went through the first gate, second gate, and went outside. I'm going to join you. Hallelujah. Amen. All the guards were still standing there. Standing there. Say the name of Jesus, the same God of Peter. That is my God. Hallelujah. No devil can prison your destiny. No devil can prison your destiny. I break the cage in Jesus' name. I break the cage in Jesus' name. I break the cage in Jesus' name. Those watching in Thailand, in Africa, in Asia, I break the cage in Jesus' name. Devil says you end this way. God says, I have a future for you. Amen. Peter, you're going to die the next day. God said, Peter, there's a future in you. Yes. There's a ministry in you. Yes. There's a calling in you. Yes. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Talk to yourself, say the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The best me is just beginning.
The
best me is just about to begin. I cannot end this way. I cannot end here. Do you believe it?
Yes.
Hallelujah. I cannot end this way, and I cannot end here. I cannot end this way, and I cannot end here. It's a devil, for your information, I cannot end this way.
I cannot end
here.
You
cannot stop me.
So
stop the worrying, stop crying, stop all the anxiety and all. You need just to be in the right place. The right ministry.
Yeah.
Bishop,
yeah.
Some Christians are locked up because they're in the wrong place.
Yeah.
Either a pastor is not for you. They're in the wrong place. Imagine if a girl came to me crying. It's one of the churches. One guy came to marry her. She went to the pastor. Pastor bring the man. The man came. He said, what? You are from which place? Say, from Lagos. How can you engage a Cameroon girl? And that was the end of the relationship. You must marry Yoruba. And the girl is in the church singing, hallelujah. Wrong place. Destiny. And she was crying because the man already just arrived there to marry. The pastor arranged it. Pastor said, sister, Catherine is better. It's from the same tribe. Can you imagine to put the city blocked because they are not positioned well?
Yeah.
Say, if they are pastor, it's not on your behalf. Oh, is it behalf? It's not on your behalf. It's a blessing to know that pastor can call, say, hello, Flo, how are you doing? I'm praying for you.
Amen.
Keep believing God. God will do it for you.
Amen.
Hello, Esther. Hey, your husband is okay. I'm praying for you, okay? Amen. Say,
my destiny
cannot end this way. Say, tell me what I am. Say, the name of Jesus.
My story
cannot end here. I want to move to be angry. Be angry. Say, my story cannot end in this chapter. Hey, say, my story cannot end this chapter. They cannot end this way. I see World Mission in the next 4 years buying a good building, expanding schools, building centers. I see young girls weddings, marrying, building a company. I see you expanding. I see you going forward. Hey, say, never give me space. Say, give me space to grow. this person grow. Hallelujah. 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 Candy is some, you know, the best you must manifest. The best you must manifest. The best you must manifest. Hallelujah. You know the story of Bartimaeus. Blind Bartimaeus, that is in Matthew 10, 46 to 47. Bartimaeus, that name Bartimaeus, Bar means son, Timaeus means unclean. Say Bar, son of unclean. People say the father was also blind. So he was a son of a man called what? Unclean. Bar Timaeus, son of Timaeus. So Bartimaeus was born in a blind state. All his life he had been crying, begging. And one day he was sitting there at the entrance of Jericho. And he heard that Jesus is passing by. And he heard about the miracles of Jesus. And he began to cry, Son of David, have mercy on me. My story cannot end this way. Say, Son of David, have mercy on me. My story cannot end this way. Shout, Son of David, have mercy on me. My story. Hey, say, Son of David, have mercy on me. I must get a good job. I must get a good husband. I must get a good family. I must build my future. I must go through my degree. I must get my doctorate. I must get my breakthrough. I must build my company. Hey, say, Son of David. Hey, Son of David. Have mercy on me. My story cannot end this way. My story cannot end this way. Amen. I think you think people will be happy with him. Those church Pharisees, they say, keep quiet. Say, keep quiet. You know, one day, I called some two pastors to the restaurant. I said, I have a plan to start a conference called World Mission. I want to bring pastors abroad. You know what they did to me? They took my name to the superintendent. Reported me. And then, the next 2 years, I was transferred. Took me out of the church, far, the different province, to stop my mission. They sent my friend to take over my church. Because of what? The dream I have. So people will share their ambition with them. They become your enemies. Say, Son of David! No power can kill this dream inside me. Sound. Say, no power can kill the dream inside me. Say, the real version of me must manifest. Tell people, the real version of me must manifest. I said, tell 10 people. The real version of you must manifest. Leave that chair, tell 10 people. Are you sure? Tell 10 people, prophesy. The real version of you must manifest. Hey, the real version of me. Are you sure? I said, tell 10 people. Tell 10 people. Leave that chair, tell 10 people. Hey, the real version of me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The real version of me must send over. The real version of me must. The real version of you must. Say, I cannot end here. My children cannot end here. My story cannot end this way. I have a future. I have a journey to end. I must attend to it. I must achieve it. The devil cannot stop me. I have a future. Hey, sit down. It's your story. Have a future. My story cannot end here. That story cannot end here. That story cannot end here. Oh my God. My story cannot end here. Can you think of a woman called Ruth in the Bible? Ruth was so blessed to get a husband to marry a Jewish young man. And the honeymoon did not last, the man died. And the mother said, okay, I'm going back to my country. Mother-in-law. Oprah said, no, I'm going back home. Ruth said, I'll stay with you. And then Ruth moved to Jerusalem, or to Bethlehem. Are you following me?
Yes.
A widow, to get married easily, is not a widow in Israel to be difficult. But this young girl, Ruth, was lit up by Naomi. Amen. And the story of this girl's behavior spread. A good girl from Moab. Hello? See, it is a curse.
A
Moab back doesn't enter a temple even after 10 generations. Read the Bible. A Moab back doesn't enter what? Even after what? But this young man married a Moab girl and brought to Israel. Even though the law was against her, the culture was against her, but she was saying, my story cannot end this way. Hey, Senator, my story cannot end this way. Before she knew, she was engaged with the boys. I got married. I gave it to other rhythm. I said, that's why you're single. Come out, that's right.
Amen.
Do what?
Come out.
Hello? Do what?
Come out.
Say the name of Jesus. I'm born a child of God from the tribe of what? Judah. Hallelujah. You're from what tribe? You're from what tribe? I see you crying. You're from what tribe? The tribe of Judah. You're from what tribe? Yes. We are sons of Abraham. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So I break the limitations.
Amen.
Say, my story cannot end here. Shout,
my story
cannot end this way. So you decide, I was here yesterday, to break limitations. Defy those limitations. So this girl Ruth, you know, they need to confess. My story cannot end this way. I must break this widowhood in your age in the name of Jesus. Say,
my story
cannot end this way. I must have my baby in righteousness, in holiness. Bishop Bali must bless my wedding. My story cannot end this way. My story cannot end this way. I must break forth. I must expand my ministry. I go around the world singing and preaching with bishops around the world. My story cannot end this way. Say, my story cannot end this way. My story cannot end this way. The best me is about to manifest. Hallelujah. Say, the best me is about to manifest. Don't despise people. Don't despise people. Amen. Because God can pick anybody.
Yes. Oh, yes.
Anybody.
Oh, yes.
And change their story.
Amen.
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 God can pick anybody.
That's right.
And change their story. There's a young man called Trump. And one day Trump went for. Is it what they call it?
Yeah, fashion show, yeah.
Fashion show.
Yeah.
And Trump sat there. There was a young girl marching like that and moving. It was a true. And Trump caught his eye, guys, and look. What's her name?
Melania.
What's her name?
Melania.
She was moving on her first time, second time. How did they move? I think they come back to my show. Can they come back to us?
Can
they come back to us? One more time. One more time again. People are seeing you around the world. Young boys, she's single. Young boys, she's single. Hallelujah. Send me an email, your text messages. Hallelujah. So some will look carefully that after the occasion was closed, some was still legally around. And then said, can I talk with you? Can we get tomorrow? And today they're in the White House. Give the Lord glory, somebody. Tell my story. Cannot end this way. Amen. There's a young girl, her name was Esther. Say Esther.
Esther.
Esther was wondering why they gave her the name Esther. Okay. Esther means Estuar. It's a star. Brightness. Illuminate. There was war and the father and mother was killed in Israel. And a young girl at that age, she was desperate. The uncle adopted her. And then there was another war again. Mordecai was captured and carried to a strange land, to Persia, to Syria, far from home. And there as a slave in a foreign land, her life was all crushed. She was living in secret. And one day the queen made a big mistake. Vashti did not honor the king. You know they said it also?
Yes.
And there was a need for 1,000 virgins to contest for a king. For a king, to become king. And, you know, Mordecai said, Esther, I have failed you. Make it. Hide your identity. Don't get that you're a slave or you're a Jew. Just go for it. And the girl went in. Amen.
Amen.
The uncle was fasting and praying. Amen. Our story cannot end this way.
Oh yes.
We came as slaves, we not end like slaves.
Amen.
We came poor, we not end poor.
Amen.
We came like refugees, cannot end like refugees. They said my story Amen. Cannot end this way.
Amen.
Hey, so never. Amen. I prophesy to you,
Amen.
Your story, the best of you,
Amen.
Is manifesting. As I prophesy to you, the best of you is coming out. As I prophesy to you, the best of you is coming out. Hallelujah. And out of 1,000 girls, oh, when the king saw her, he said, please, cancel the rest.
Yeah. I don't need the rest again.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Listen now. Hello. They took the crown to the crown and placed on her head to be the queen of the land. Oh, Karan, it is Sambayana. To see myself in the glory. It's to see myself in my honor. I see myself in my dignity. I see myself in my royalty. I see myself in my inheritance. I see myself in my prophecy. I see myself in the promise. I see myself in my destiny. My story cannot end this way. Hallelujah. If this Esther could get a breakthrough in a strange land, God changed her story. God turned this around. And I feel this morning, this word is for somebody. Hallelujah. You know, Bishop, you know that somebody in King Saul's palace framed a good story about David that promoted him.
Yeah.
The king said, I need someone to come and come. Say, oh, there's a man who is a good warrior. Which one did he fight? You know, said also, king was possessed also, needed a musician. Somebody said, there's a boy who is a warrior, he's a fighter. He was a shepherd. Eh? That man is a warrior. He's a musician, also what? David was running behind those. And that man's testimony, they brought David into the palace to play for King Saul. Amen. And his story changed.
Yes.
Never. Son of this. Today, I don't know what you are chasing after. I pity my wife, you know, because she's a student, she's working. She leaves the house sometime 8 p.m., come back 8 a.m., sleep for 2 hours, go to school. How do they do that? Yes, she's doing it. I cannot live that our life. It's not easy. For me, I need my sleep at least from 12 o'clock midnight to 5 a.m. Say my story. I cannot end this way. How many of you have desires that you don't know how to fulfill them? Let me be sincere. Amen. So we declare this morning, I will not live in a dream world. I will not live in what? I want to enter into the reality.
Yes.
In my future.
Yes.
We are praying the same thing. Amen. God bless you, please. Walk, just walk.
Let's do it better. Let's do it better. Let's do it better. Let's do it better. Lay your hands. Bible says as you clap your hands, you put judgment on your enemies. It means that sometimes you cannot be praying. Just clap your hands. Clap your hands. Slap them every situation. Every unwanted situation. Every difficult situation. Every enemy in your life. Whoever has sent them, just keep clapping. I prophesy in your clapping. May your clap become like a sword. May it become like a two-edged sword. Break in the village. Break in your tribe.
Mission International Worship Center is dedicated to healing broken hearts, giving hope, and saving souls through the love of God. Located in Lanham, Maryland, we are called to create a loving and caring community for all people, and we are committed to see you grow your faith in the Word of God and to see you happy and blessed in life. We are strategically positioned in Maryland at such a time like this to be available to provide counseling, guidance, and praying, and believing God for a fresh move of God as never seen before. Our heart's desire is to see all men come to the knowledge of the saving grace of Jesus Christ. If you've been searching for a place where real people who have experienced the love and power of Jesus Christ, World Mission International Worship Center may very well be the perfect fit. You're welcome too, where good things happen. We love you and are waiting for you in Jesus' name.